We're back with the roundtable. And Jason, tell me something I don't know.
Yesterday, the mayor of Ferguson was reelected. Okay. Yes, the same mayor, Matthew Knowles, who was there during the riots, who denigrated Mike Brown, got reelected for the second time since the Ferguson riots. And what's worse, even though there's 24,000 registered voters in the city, only 1% turned out to
vote. What was the minority turnout?
The minority turnout was still really low. It was only 1%.
Why was there a get out the vote campaign?
There was. It wasn't effective. I did an interview with the people today. They say that the folks are as angry as they are at Knowles. He's the devil they know. He beat an African-American woman for that position.
Whoa, Michelle.
my tell you something you don't know says it all. I've got one tweet for you by Bernice King, daughter of Martin Luther King. Yeah. If only daddy would have known about the power of Pepsi. Yesterday, Pepsi had to pull an ad starring reality star Kendall Jenner, who ends racism by handing a cop a bottle, a can of Pepsi. She's, you know, she's modeling, she's in a photo shoot, she joins the protesters, and this white woman ends racism by handing the cop
Coke was the
Pepsi.
Democrat drink, and Pepsi was the Republican drink.
Well, Pepsi's in a lot of trouble.
It had something to do with Joan Crawford, the actress. I don't know. John Brayman.
Okay, for years, progressive rock fans were absolutely outraged that the group Yes was not inducted into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. So 2 years ago, Republican-Democrat consultants got together. They're being inducted bipartisan.
Thank you. Two big ones from him tonight. Thank you, John Brayman, Jason Johnson, and Michelle Bernard. We'll be right back.